It was a day just like any other. I was sitting in my office, twiddling my thumbs and asking myself where my next case would come from. Okay, on my door it said, Carlo, investigations of all kinds. But lately, there hadn't been much to investigate. I drank my last shot of whiskey and considered whether I shouldn't have listened to my father after all when he offered me a job in his pizzeria, when suddenly the door opened.
Ich habe gehört, Sie sollen der Beste sein.
Hm, schon möglich. Was kann ich für Sie tun?
Finden Sie alles über die Uni Oldenburg heraus.
Vergessen Sie es.
She told me she had recently graduated from high school and needed my help. She wanted to apply to a university, but didn't know how to begin. It didn't make much sense to me.
Na okay, okay. Ich übernehme Ihren Fall.
We discussed my fee, and I told her I'd see what I could do.
Ich verlasse mich auf Sie, Carlo.
Sie hören von mir. Wie war Ihr Name?
Ingrid Bergmann.
To make sure I wasn't being followed, I took the long way around. Pretty clever of me. Student seeks ideal place to study. I've had a few hard cases to crack in the past, but this was something else. Ingrid Bergmann. Ingrid Bergmann. Hadn't I heard that name somewhere before?
As time goes by.
Oh yeah, wasn't that my old piano teacher's name? I drove through the North German lowlands to Oldenburg. The countryside was nice and green. I'd already found out a few solid facts. Oldenburg is in northwest Lower Saxony. It's only about 30 minutes on the train from Bremen. Holland is right next door, and the North Sea is just over the road. As I was driving through town, I went through the case in my mind. Why did Ingrid think that I, of all people, could help her? What did she want to study anyway? And how did my old piano teacher fit into this story? One thing you have to learn if you're a private detective is to remain inconspicuous. With a car, I just stuck out. I needed a different plan. First, I decided to get more information about this little town on the River Hunter. In fact, the town was larger than I expected. I estimated the population to be around 159,752. But it was still small enough to be able to cycle everywhere. As far as I could see, this was a nice place to live. My informant at the market told me that people who come to Oldenburg once always come back, unless they just stay. I believed her. She had an honest face. I decided that the town was fine. While I was wandering around, I tried to find out more about the university. I found a man and made him an offer he couldn't refuse. He gave me a few addresses. Without being noticed, I managed to have a look at a few student flats in the middle of town. They had just about everything. Single rooms, double rooms, shared flats for between 100 and 250 euros a month, including bills, and internet access in every room. Now, they really didn't have that in my day, but then I hadn't been to university. I thought hard about what to do next. I needed something firm, something solid. Something warm. The university would have to wait. I was just looking at the menu when my mobile rang.
Und schon was rausgefunden?
Schöne Aussichten hier.
I told her about the high quality of life, the low rent, the friendly people, the many parks, and all the bars, cafes, cinemas, and theaters, as well as all the other ways to spend your free time. I was beginning to sound like a tourist brochure. I even told her about the nightlife and that Oldenburg would be a good place to study. We talked for a while, and I mentioned that there were lakes for swimming nearby, and that the North Sea was not far.
Hier ist es fast wie in Italien. Die Leute sitzen im Freien und trinken Espresso.
Und was ist mit der Uni?
Na, so weit bin ich noch nicht.
Ich bezahle sie doch nicht dafür, dass sie mit dem Fahrrad durch Oldenburg fahren, Espresso trinken und Gott weiß was tun.
So I just shut up and took notes on what she wanted me to find out. She called it Carlo's checklist. I deduced with lightning speed that the first point was taken care of. The next morning, I carried on with my investigation. It didn't take long until I found my first clue. As I approached the university, I went over my list one more time. First, I decided to check out the situation on campus. I thought to myself, this is going to be a lot of work. But I found my way around without any problems. The system was self-explanatory. Everything was so clearly laid out. Was there some sort of secret behind it all? I stopped for a moment to catch my breath, then went towards the new auditorium and interrogated a few suspicious-looking characters. If you want answers, you've got to ask questions.
Die Universität Oldenburg wurde 1974 gegründet und ist somit eine der jüngsten Universitäten Deutschlands.
Rund 11.000 Studentinnen und Studenten sind an der Universität Oldenburg angeschrieben. Es gibt 40 Fächer mit Magister, Master, Bachelor, Diplom, natürlich auch Lehramt.
Die Lehrerausbildung spielt an der Karl-von-Ossietzky-Universität eine große Rolle. Hier werden Lehrerinnen und Lehrer aller Schulformen ausgebildet. So, die Stunde ist um. Fürs nächste Mal wiederholen wir, was wir heute gelernt haben.
Ich wiederhole. Forschungsschwerpunkte sind unter anderem Meeresbiologie, alternative Energien, Psychoakustik, Informatik, Stadtsoziologie und Kurt Tucholsky.
Also wenn ihr mich fragt, dann sollte das Studienfach vor allen Dingen den persönlichen Neigungen entsprechen und Spaß machen.
Mein Name ist Hase, ich weiß von nichts.
Die Leute von der zentralen Studienberatung und vom Immatrikulationsamt, die helfen gerne weiter bei allen Fragen rund um Uni und Studium. Oh bitte, gern geschehen.
Mein Rat an alle Erstsemester: Cool bleiben, Augen auf, fleißig auf Partys gehen und Leute um Rat fragen, die wissen, wo es lang geht. Mich zum Beispiel.
I now had a lot of answers, but I still had more questions. What do you need to start your first semester? I was able to find that out too. The new student needs three things: information, a lecture list, and last but not least, confidence. I'd have to work on that with my therapist. I went on and found myself standing in front of a revolving door. Some people say that every door leads to an opportunity. I wondered where this one would lead. It led to the university library. I began to sniff around carefully. Free access to the shelves made it easy to find out what I was looking for. Excellent. Anyone who wants to look something up or do research on the internet can come here from 9 in the morning until midnight. Now I had the basics, I decided to go undercover.
Mir gefällt die Forschung an dieser Uni, besonders im Bio- und Umweltschutz.
Hier herrscht eine anregende Lernatmosphäre.
Hier ist alles überschaubar und man hat schnell den Durchblick.
Ich finde das breite Fächerangebot gut.
Ich finde die Ausbildung hier sehr praxisnah.
Das Mensaessen ist leider sehr gut.
Oh, enger Kontakt zu den Dozenten.
Was ich an dieser Uni so gut finde, ist ganz klar, sie ist in einer Stadt, die hat die optimale Größe.
Gutes Lernklima hier und man wächst mit den Aufgaben.
Wenn man nicht mehr weiter weiß oder die Orientierung verliert, gibt es genug Einrichtungen und Personen, die einem weiterhelfen und beraten.
Man lernt schnell Leute kennen und findet Kontakte.
New friends? How am I supposed to meet people here?
Hey, Carlo! Kommst du zur Party am Freitag?
Ja.
Bei Birgit in der WG.
Hey, Carlo! Hi!
Hi!
Ja, oh. Wolltest du was zur Party einladen?
Kommst du auch zur Party?
Ja, ja,
kommst du auch zur Party?
Ja, ja,
ja. Kommst du auch zur
Party? Ja, ja, ja. Kommst du auch,
oder? Honestly, I would never have thought I could be so happy. And then when I saw the sports hall, I went head over heels. The university sports program has at least 100 different activities to choose from. You can also act in the university theater, play in the university orchestra, be entertained by the student cabaret, or simply take a dip in the university pool.
Diese Uni taucht was.
I took a break to make some notes and watch the students having fun for a while. Then I realized I was suddenly very hungry. After all, you can't work on an empty stomach. The food in the cafeteria was very good. It had been a long time since I'd eaten so well. And it was pretty cheap too. My compliments to the chef. Afterwards, I sat in the cafe and reviewed the case. There were things I liked about this university. A nice size. Not too big. People know each other. Most of the things on my checklist had been ticked off. Everything fitted together. The city, the university, the students, and me. Suddenly I realized what I had to do. I wanted to study here too, learn a proper profession, earn a decent wage. I'd have to start by finding a nice flat and a part-time job. Maybe I could get a scholarship. I had to get moving. It was only a few days to the beginning of term. I called Ingrid Bergman to tell her it hadn't been easy, but I'd solved her case at last. When she heard that I was going to study at the University of Oldenburg myself, all she said was, "How clever of you, Carlo," and hung up. At the party in Birgit's apartment, I told my new friends about my decision. They thought it was great and gave me lots of tips for studying. Things started to take care of themselves. There happened to be a room free in the flat, and I could move in right away. As I remember, it was a really good evening. I was as nervous as my first day at school when I went to the university to register. The beginning of my new life. I looked at my enrollment papers and could hardly believe it. I was a psychology student. Well, it was exciting to me. The big moment had come. My first semester. It began with an introduction week. We had to work out which lectures and seminars to go to, and they explained how to organize our time. I hadn't thought it would be so much fun. Oh, and I saw Ingrid Bergman again, after a statistics lecture. Which brings us to the end of our case.
Frau Bergman.
Carlo, lang nichts von dir gehört.
Tut mir leid, ich habe viel zu viel zu tun. Einführungsveranstaltungen, Vorlesungen, Seminare.
Ah, ich verstehe.
Und gleich habe ich eine Arbeitsgruppe.
Aha. Im ersten Semester sollte man sich den Stundenplan nicht zu voll packen. Weniger ist mehr.
Was soll das heißen?
Naja, ich studiere jetzt auch hier. Und jetzt möchte ich ans Meer fahren. Hast du Lust? Oh. Los, komm, pack deine Badehose ein, wir fahren los, ja?
Auf fein.
Okay.
You, me and the University of Oldenburg. I think this is the beginning of a beautiful friendship.